بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. الله سبحانه وتعالى سيد عند القرآن والليل إذا يغشى والنهار إذا تجلى وما خلق الذكر والأنثى إن سعيكم لشتى. You know, what we do is different on a daily basis. 6 billion or 7 billion that people live in this planet. When we come out in the morning and we leave our houses, every single person's got something different than the other one in their mentality, in their head. So some of you do good and some of you do bad. I'm not talking about those who's doing good now. In this video, I would like just to talk to and about those who think what they've done is wrong, or maybe what they're doing is actually terribly wrong, no matter what it is. And I'm talking to you from Islamic perspective. Those who committed sins against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for whatever reason, neglect, arrogance, carelessness, whatever it is, accidentally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, if you repent, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your repentance. Actually, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is encouraging us to come back over and over in repentance. It's not over. If you literally came out from your home upsetting your parents, if you're a young person especially, if you were involved in crime, petty crime, bad crime, if you were involved in gang issue, stabbing, killing, anything, name it. Any sin that you committed against other human being, or against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or even against ourselves, yourselves, no one's clear. Every single person is, you know, a guilty in a way or another. However, khayrul khatta'un at-tawwabun, the best among those who make mistakes, those who repent, they are the better. But if you continue your mistakes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you the chance after the chance after the chance, and then you ruin your life. You think that you're going to continue with these mistakes, with these sins, endlessly, unaccounted to. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will catch you red-handed. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caught many people red-handed. Some people got shot, some people got stabbed, some people got, you know, imprisoned, some people died of natural car accident. Whatever it is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will catch you and you will be brought in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then at that time you need to answer it. But before that, you have a chance to repent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Oh my servant, oh my ibad, الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ, those who committed sins and did so much mistakes, لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ, do not give up of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy and forgiveness. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا, Allah forgives all the sins, every single sin that we ever commit, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives it. So let's repent and let's go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask him for forgiveness. Don't let the shaitan play you. Devil likes playing you. You are guilty, you smoke, you gambled, you took interests, you stabbed someone, you did this sin, you committed adultery, a'udhu billah, you did this or that. All these sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe it. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn these sins to good deeds if you repent. You know, all your mistakes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn it to good deeds. Imagine that. You make mistake, you make sin, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his mercy turns it to good deeds. This is to show you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there's no people between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't need to go to a scholar or this person. It's just between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't need to even to convince and tell people about what you did. Just repent. Go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah will accept you. Allah will accept your repentance. No questions about this. He said that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. He said, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. And this israf as well, and the word ibad is not only specifically for the Muslims, by the way, even for the non-Muslims. Allah is told, saying, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِي, my servant. Everybody, all of us are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala servant. So let's repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and take that burden. Shaitan, on the other hand, is promising us, fuqr, you know, poorness in our moral behavior. Poorness, not the financial poorness, like, you know, you don't have like a, you're poor when you don't have financial mean. We all human beings are poor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only rich. Let's establish that, number one. Number two, when we establish that we are poor, then we're not talking about that financial mean. We talk about the moral, our morals, you know, our respect, our manners. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about. Our shaitan is promising us, if we continue smoking weed, selling drugs, committing adultery, doing it, that you will have a better day. And it's lies. His promise is false. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. This is a quick reminder to me first, for myself first, and to all of you, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.